official introduction, by golly, lets us know we got a good group here today, David. Hello again, everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Brown. We're right along ringside. We are ready to do it, Dave.
Oh, we're going to have Jerry Oski in here. He will be in the opening match of the day on Championship Wrestling. Following that, the PYT, Norvell and Coco are back.
Oh, boy.
They are going to be in action here in a tag team match today. Tojo will be here. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, in a single match. Dutch Mantell. The Fabulous One, Stan and Steve, coming up in tag team action a little later. Also, we will be looking at Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, and Lanny Poffo will also be team. More action coming up today, too.
Yeah, by golly, I guess we got to do what we normally do, and that is acknowledge the fact that we have a new AWA Southern Heavyweight Champion. And coming out right now, manager extraordinary Tux Newman and the new champion, the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Have a cigar, Russell. Wait a minute. I want to give a cigar to Mr. Brown here. Have a cigar. Listen, let me tell you something. My man, Macho Man, and I have been in Hollywood most of the week. We threw a big party, a victory party. I had Ryan and Farrah there. That's O'Neill and Fawcett. I had Kim Novak there. I had Sylvester Stallone. They were all there. There was just a small, intimate party. 200 people. 200 people. What did they want to do? All they wanted to do was touch the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and the new Southern Heavyweight Champion. And look at that belt. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, I know. It is a belt that is a prestigious one. And there is no question about it. You did exactly what you said you would do. You arranged for the Southern belt to be in the possession of one of your guys. And I think it is only fair that we've acknowledged he is the new...
something right now, Lance Russell, because you didn't want this to happen. Eddie Merlin didn't want this to happen. Jerry Jarrett didn't want this to happen. There was a dethroning of the king. Oh, yeah, it was. Reality.
Okay.
The king has been dethroned. Jackie Fargo sitting at home. Everybody out there, just understand one thing. When I come down that aisle, I want the aisle real, real wide. Because then there's a chance that you won't get hurt. Yeah, I'm the new Southern Heavyweight Champion. And they tried to hold me back for a long period of time. But Tux Newman freed me, and the cream rises to the top. Congratulate me, man.
Listen,
congratulate me,
Randy,
man.
You got
do
the
it,
belt.
Baby!
We've already said you got the belt in there. I think it's nice that we take a look and see exactly how you got the belt.
We got a videotape. You're not doing nothing. Russell, I'll have you fired. You won't work here or Hollywood or Podunk, Idaho or anywhere. You are not showing no tape. I'm going to tell you right now, no film, no tape. I'll buy Channel 5, and you will not see any kind of film. Listen, I've got something coming up even bigger than film. I've got my boy, Sweet Daddy Siki, coming on, and you ain't going to believe your eyes. I'll tell you that much.
We've got the videotape of the action.
No videotape! I told you, you're not showing any videotape.
You're proud of him having the belt.
He won the belt fair and square, scientific, right in the ring. It was 1, 2, 3. Waller was on his back. He was on his feet. He won, and that's all there is to it. He is the champion, recognizing that fact.
We're not, okay, now,
the
Randy.
The king has been dethroned, Lance Russell. Tell everybody.
Yeah, let's take a break here and get away from this.
Set to go with a one fall, 10-minute time limit match. Introducing from Memphis, Tennessee, at 231 pounds. Over on the left of your screen, that is Bill Rose. Going against him from Hartford, Connecticut, 230 pounds, Jerry Oski. This match, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Your referee is Jerry Calhoun.
Both of these guys similar in size. Bell time, and we're ready to go as Bill Rose going against Jerry Oski. Oski is new to our area. He is not new to professional wrestling. Well, relatively new, but he's a fine-looking athlete. I saw him in one match, and he's impressive. He's a good athlete, and you can tell he spent some time on that body as he's worked out hard to get it.
Been working in the gym, no doubt about it. Nice move, put Bill Rose down to the mat. Now, Rose is no small customer. As a matter of fact, he has a slight weight advantage over Oski. But Jerry put him down to the mat. Rose using that weight to force Jerry Oski back on the rope. Muskie and the referee together move Bill Rose back away from the ropes. Nice takedown. Unfortunately for Jerry Oski, he was too close to the ropes when he rolled Bill Rose's shoulder down to the mat. So no count started.
Fired around behind him in good shape, though, for a big man. And Rose, with a head scissor, takes him in the side mare there. But Oski, with a good head scissors on Bill Rose, has him down on the deck. Not a pinning hole, but it is sure a punishing one. I'm impressed with the number of pure athletes that are coming into professional wrestling. You see these guys with athletic backgrounds and other sports, and Jerry Oski is one of them.
Bill Rose back out to the center of the ring. Jerry Oski slipped around behind him. Nice move. Flipped him right over the shoulder, put him on the mat, and now puts a reverse face lock on there.
Got a set of arms on him, too, as he is really squeezing down on Bill Rose.
Yeah, Rose, so far, if what's going on in the match is any indication of what we're going to see from Jerry Oski, Mr. Rose has expended a lot of energy just trying to get out of tough holds that were put on him. Ooh.
A little irritation move by Oski.
That hurts, too. Bill Rose going to have to shake it off, get back on his feet, and come back into action. Jerry Oski pretty much in control of things so far, and we're about 2 minutes into the action. Oski with Rose into the rope. Upper arm as Rose came off of there. Here's the covers. Count is one, but only a one count. Oski. Left that face lock on there again. What the referee was just doing was checking to make sure the hold is up on the chin, not a choke hold. He ruled it was all right.
Oski, once again, is out of the Northeast, but we hope we're going to have a chance to talk to Jerry Appich. He does have a Southern connection. We'll get into that a little bit later, but he's from Hartford, Connecticut.
He's a battler. Look at him go with that right hand. Bill Rose knocked off his feet, down to the mat. Oski picks him up, fires him into the rope, sets, and power slams in. Count is one, two, it's over. Jerry Oski gets the win in 2 minutes, 57 seconds of action. The young man from Hartford, Connecticut comes in here, and look at him go. Here's the way he wrapped it up. As he grabs Bill Rose, weighing in, again, slightly heavier than Oski, but no barriers. Oski picks him up, and watch him follow him down with a power slam. The referee counts three, and Jerry Oski has the win.
Well, yeah, I'll tell you, Jerry, congratulations. That was quite a power slam you finished Rose off with, and he's no featherweight by any means.
Well, no, he's in fact a bit heavier than me, you know, but I've been training a long time. I'm a little excited now because it is my first time here.
Yeah, Jerry, we wanted to welcome you to Championship Wrestling. We don't have too many fellas out of the Northeast that are in this area. I mentioned to Dave a minute ago, you do have kind of a Southern connection one way or another, you were telling me about your mother, I believe.
Well, yes. My mom was born down south in Chattanooga, so this is a home away from home for me.
All right.
I feel right at home.
We were talking also that I compliment you, and I've been very pleased with the number of pure athletes that are into professional wrestling. Actually, wrestling was not, of all the athletics that you participated in, was not your original choice. You were a baseball player, right?
Yeah, at first, you know.
You really had your eyes on the majors and all, and then all of a sudden something happened.
Yeah, well, this is something that's in your blood, you know.
Yeah.
I guess I was born with it. It was only a matter of time before it came out. You know, but the best in championship wrestling is here in the Mid-South. That's exactly why I'm here. I have an open contract, which means that I'll face anyone at any time. So just bring it on because I'm trained and ready.
Okay, fine. Now, we caught you at a disadvantage time when you're a little out of breath
well,
after
really
taking
disadvantage.
That win.
It's just that I'm so high. The excitement is in the air here, and it's in my blood right now. You're going to be seeing a lot of me.
I sure hope so. Thanks, Jerry, and good luck to you here in the future with Championship Wrestling. Okay, Dave, let's just continue and get right back in the ring. We're going to be bringing back a team we have not seen in quite some time. Tux Newman coming out. And behind him, the PYT.
Yes, indeed. Led by Mr. Newman this time as they step up onto the ring. This is going to be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit tag team match. Introducing from Memphis, Tennessee, David Haskins and his partner from Hamden, Connecticut, Billy Travis. And going against him at a total weight of 437 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee and Union City, Tennessee, Norvell Austin and Coco Ware, the PYT Express. Their manager, Tux Newman, in the corner, referee Jerry Calhoun, and we are set to go with tag team action.
Okay, and by golly, talking about a couple of guys that can go with all the other things that we might say, and we won't start off with any bad feeling right away, except I do not like them associating with Tux Newman. Norvell and Coco are some kind of battlers. These guys can get down and get hard. And Coco Ware, without a question, one of the finest drop kicks I've ever seen in professional wrestling. Right out, starting off with David Haskins, Norvell on the outside. Billy Travis on the ring side as Coco starting out against Haskins. And now,
who cares who their opponents are? You're talking about PYT, pretty young things. They got to be gorgeous, and all the people can see them in living color. They are just the most beautiful wrestlers that God ever put on the face of the earth. And let me tell you something. These kind of people, they excel in all kinds of sports. They excel in basketball. They excel in field and track. And, you know, they are just great when it comes to boxing. They dominate the sport of boxing. And, of course, look what they're doing in the ring right now. Isn't that just great?
Norvell is in there now. Plants a big elbow on David Haskin in there. Well, those are cherished words from Tux Newman you're hearing. I want to make sure that you... Holy mackerel, he was up 6.5 feet in the air.
That impressed you, huh?
He kicked David Haskin's head off. I mean, really caught him with a double footer. We told you this is one of the great... That's a double team backdrop, and Haskins down being pounded hard.
Devastating. And you know what's best of all, Lance Russell? You know what's best of all?
What is
they
that?
Do what they are told.
Oh. Norvell Austin with David Haskins. Haskins.
Give it to him, baby!
He needs a tag on Billy Travis.
Give it to him, Coco. You lay it on him.
Coco Ware and Norvell Austin, better known as the PYT, coming into championship wrestling. And right off the bat, they are blistering David Haskins in the middle of that ring. He needs to talk to Billy Travis over there and get up where he can tag him, get him in that ring, because David is taking a terrible pounding.
These people know their business. When they get in the ring, they do exactly what I want them to do. And as you can see, they are crippling this poor boy.
And I'm sure that makes you happy, Tux.
Oh.
Norvell watches him in the air. Body slam with that arm still behind him, and Haskin in the center of the ring. David has not been able to make an offensive move of any stature at all. And Norvell drops down. Looks like he caught him with a headbutt down on the...
That's not Norvell. That's Coco Ware. Can't you
Coco,
see?
Coco, yeah.
You need glasses on your glasses. Call it straight. These are the PYT, okay. The pretty young thing. And don't forget it, Russell.
Tux, I think we can handle a commentary here. You're disturbing my rhythm. I might tell you that right out here.
You're annoying me today, Russell. You don't usually annoy me. Usually you show intelligence. But today, I wonder where you left him at home or not.
Norvell Austin back in the ring after a tag from Coco Ware, and David Haskins has not been able to get that corner. He swings back with a good right hand on Norvell. Here's another one of these guys we were talking about, athletes, a fine football player. Haskins caught by Coco, and he makes the tag on Billy Travis. Billy is a matter... Yeah, he made the tag. I saw the tag. You don't have to see the tag. The referee saw it. Travis in. Sunset flip. Coco.
Come on, Coco.
Drops down. Oh, smart move by Ware. He resisted.
Coco. I told him to do that. That's why it's smart.
Oh, is that it? Going for the suplex in the air. Travis.
Oh, yeah.
No suplex. He drove him down into the canvas.
Wasn't that pretty?
Oh. Travis. Had that neck jammed as Coco got him up in a suplex. There's that flying press. One, two.
That's it. That is it, Russell.
PYT. Impressive victory over David Haskins and Billy Travis. He hurt Travis. He took him straight up. I thought he was into a suplex. Take a look at this. And drives him straight down into the canvas. Good night. The full weight of Travis behind that neck as he drove into the canvas. Norvell then came flying across, got him with a press. They're trying to help Billy out over there. And we hope he hasn't really jammed that neck to where he's going to be hurt. Eddie Marlin coming out. That's one we hadn't seen before, and the PYT, the ones that administered, they're the winners, and we got more action. Be back in a moment. Okay, we've got plenty of action coming up. I was just looking over some of the matches to come before we see Coco and Mr. X and Randy Savage. I want to get the King out here. I'll say it right off the top. Not as comfortable a situation as when Jerry had the belt, but that's the part of it. I think the thing that irritates me the most is the way that you lost the belt to Randy Savage, Jerry.
Well, Lance, you know, I don't really want to talk so much about the way I lost the belt. Tux Newman was out here saying he didn't want to show the film. I don't really want to see the film
well,
either.
No, I think it's only fair that the people have...
Well, you're talking about past history, Lance. It's no. You don't need to live in the past. The belt was lost. That's all there is to it. We don't, you know, I think there's not anybody out here that has any doubts that Tux Newman has something to do with the match. All I got to do now is think about the future, Lance.
Yeah, I understand. You want to rematch Jerry and all, but... It is only fair because of the way that they're out here bragging about what a great thing it was and all of that. And sure, they got the belt. But I think it's only fair, and I really insist that the people have an opportunity to see what Newman had to do with the match in there, Jerry. And I want to show it right now. It's, if you will, please, to bear with us on this, because take a look at the end of the action that took place when Jerry Lawler lost his Southern heavyweight title to Randy Savage. Pay close attention, if you will, please. The strap comes down. Lawler's bumping Savage. Referee trying to stop him. End of the turnbuckles in the air, and as Lawler with the slammy, boy, weakened from 24 minutes and a half of wrestling, almost fell over. The referee knocked down. Newman pulls the legs of Savage, gets him to the underneath the ropes. Lawler going after Tux Newman. Drills. There it was. Now, I know that you saw that. First, Newman is back there grabbing at your leg. He all right, come on, Tux. Now this.
You put him up to this, Lawler.
He didn't put us up to anything about it.
That's
people garbage. Needed to
That's
see
That's baloney. They didn't see anything. What they saw is something that Lawler doctored up. He had no business.
He didn't doctor
I'm
anything.
I'm going to sue you, Lawler. I am going to put you out of business.
All right.
I'm going to fix you. Right now, I'm going to fix you.
I tell you, if you know what's good for you, you better get out of here and leave him.
Boy, in here, you better.
He's always going to do something in there, and all we were going to do was give the people an opportunity to show in there. There's no question about it. He had a hold of your leg. He distracted you, pulled you over there, and then said, all right, now, Tux, we're not going to have any trouble in here. We don't want any kind of trouble going in here. I know, sweet daddy Seeky, and you brought
this
him in.
This is my boy. He just got off the plane from Europe. He's here right now. Look at him, Lawler. Yeah. Look at him.
No trouble. Now, we don't want any trouble out here, Seeky, so if you just sell it, no problem. Now, come on, Tux. I don't want any kind of difficulties or any problems out here. Seeky, the man's not afraid of you, but please, we don't need any kind of fight out here. Sweet Daddy Seeky, one of your guys, I am sure.
Please,
Jerry.
I mean, you just might as well get him out of here and get yourself out of here right now.
I don't have to get anybody out.
How are you? How are you?
What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Just a minute. Just 1 second. You think you know this man. But I'll tell you one thing. I know him. And a lot of my people in Canada knows this man. I remember we needed help. I do quite a number of benefits in Canada. And I sent a wire to try to get this man down there. And my wire was answered. This man hopped a plane and came straight to Canada. As a matter of fact, he was only supposed to stay 2 weeks. He wound up staying a whole month, and he would not accept any expense money. And I'll tell you one thing, Jerry, I like to say, from me and my people in Canada, I wish you all the luck in getting the title back. Tut, 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 you just wait a minute. I have something to say to you as well. I'm not your boy. I am not a boy. Not only that, I heard you, what you were saying about them, they. Well, if the fellas that you're managing, just a minute, don't interrupt me. The fellas that you're managing, if they will accept being called boy or they or them, I heard you say that they're only good in football, baseball, and other things. Well, let me tell you something. Just a minute. I came all the way from Europe. All the way from Europe. And I knew that I would have to wrestle Jerry. But under the circumstances, you calling me boy, them, they, I don't need that. I might have to leave tomorrow, but I will not let you manage me. Because I don't like words like that. Boy, them, they.
Speaky, you signed a contract with me. You understand, man?
Well, don't worry,
you don't fulfill
about
the contract. You're never going to wrestle. You're never going to wrestle anywhere. I'll see
well,
to that.
Listen, don't worry. This is what I think about your contract. That's what I think about your contract. And Doug, let me tell you something. I don't even want you in my sight. You have the nerve to call me a boy. I don't want you in my sight.
I think I'm going to like this man
you'll
right
pay
here.
You'll pay,
Jerry.
Okay.
You'll pay. I'll make sure you'll never wrestle anywhere.
Hey.
I'll see you. I'm going to play.
Maybe that shows you can't tell everybody what to do.
Let me tell you something. I might have hurt my plans around here. I hope not. But I might have to leave tomorrow. But I tell you one thing. I will not let that man manage me.
Well, I appreciate those sentiments, Jerry.
Lance, let me say something. You know, I heard you announce last week that Sweet Daddy Seeky was going to be wrestling in here. Now, I met this man about 7 years ago, and he's been a wrestling star for many, many years now.
International star.
Not only that, he wrestled up in Canada. He also does a lot of charity work up there. He worked with a crippled children's hospital in Canada. That's what he was talking about. I did go up there, as did a lot of other wrestlers, and we helped out, tried to raise a lot of money up there. That's why I was so disappointed, Seeky, when I heard that you were going to be here wrestling for Tux Newman. You don't need a jerk like Tux Newman, and I'm glad to see you see the light on this kind of a jerk.
I'll tell you one thing. I just don't, I don't like that kind of talk, and I'd rather leave.
No,
I'd rather leave.
Let me say this.
No, don't leave.
No, exactly. Let me say this. We don't want you to leave. The people in the Memphis area, the people in the South here, have not seen this man wrestle, and I want them to have a chance to see him wrestle, and we want you to stay. We want you to wrestle. I'm going to talk to I'll go back here and talk to Eddie Marlin. Have you got your tights?
You don't have to. I don't need tights. We can do it right now. We can do it just right there.
Hey, I tell you, whether you got a contract with him or not, I want to see you go. I've heard about Sweet Daddy Seeky for a long time.
No way. We got to get a match. We got to get Eddie Marlin to get a match.
He's not slowing down, Jerry, I don't believe. Going into the ring now, Sweet Daddy Seeky is over talking to Tojo Yamamoto. Tojo is scheduled to go in. He's got his street clothes on. Sweet Daddy Seeky, is that okay, Eddie, huh? Yeah, I like that attitude myself. Sweet Daddy Seeky in his street clothes, Mr. X, who was going against Tojo Yamamoto. And let me get over here by the bell, Jerry, as it looks like we're going to get a match and get to see Sweet Daddy Seeky. Whoa! He grabbed him. Big hip toss again.
Hey, Lance, all I can tell you is that, as I said, this guy has been wrestling for a number of years. One of the top black wrestlers in the entire country. He's got a name that's preceded him all over the place. And he just hadn't been wrestling in the States for a while. He's been on a tour of Europe. He's wrestled in Canada for a long, long time. And I'm just glad for the people here to get to see this man go. And there's a specialty right there.
Look at that son of a gun go. One, two, three. And did it take him a short time? You got it. 34 seconds, Dave. So much for Mr. X. And Sweet Daddy Seeky really putting some moves on Mr. X as he put him down. And by golly, I'll tell you what, in his street clothes yet. He's over there with a good group of Cub Scouts that we have. And we were tickled to death, and he ran up there in the ring and decided to do it. I was even more tickled that he tore up that contract of Tux Newman's so that he doesn't have to horse with Tux Newman anymore. Daddy, hey, congratulations. You didn't take long right there, buddy.
No.
And you can even do better than that with tights on, right?
I can do a lot better. A lot better with tights. And I'll say again, that Newman, I don't know why he brought me all the way here. I was touring. I was touring in Europe.
No, stay out there. We got
with
a
my band.
Go ahead.
And I was playing music. And he brought me all the way down here just to call me boy. I'll tell you something. I'd like to tell my people out there, if the promoter will give me permission to wrestle down here, you can rest assured that you will not be sorry that I'm here.
I like it. I like it. Talk to Eddie Marlin back there. Sweet Daddy Seeky, delighted to have you here on Championship Wrestling. Thank you, fellas, for coming out here with Sweet Daddy. And whoa, he gave us quite a demonstration.
Boy,
in a hurry, babe.
Wow.
I'll tell you, Sweet Daddy Seeky, and I think the biggest thing I loved about it was the fact it was a shock to Tux Newman when he tore that contract up. We're going to take time out. Be back in a moment. For more action coming up, and in the ring right now is David Johnson. He'll have the task going against the new AWA Southern Heavyweight Champion, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. And of course, Newman will be back out here with Savage. You can bet on it. Yeah, okay. I noticed.
back down there right there.
Okay.
And I want you to leave that right there.
You put it there and leave it right there. That's fine. Okay, if we can get him in a ring, we'll see if we can get some action underway.
This is going to be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Introducing from Memphis, Tennessee, at 203 pounds, David Johnson. And going against him from Sarasota, Florida, 235 pounds, the holder of the Southern Heavyweight Championship belt, Macho Man Randy Savage.
Bell time, and before we even got the bell pulled, as quick as the referee moved out from between them, Savage fired on David Johnson, pitches him outside the ring, goes up on the top rope, comes firing out of it. Watch him. Oh, wham, right down on Johnson, who comes back almost into our camera. And the Macho Man, okay, hey, get him back in the ring, Rip. David Johnson taking a pounding as the Macho Man slamming down on him. Fires him back up inside the ring, and Macho Man Randy Savage, while absolutely, totally disconnected from any kind of sense, picks him up, wouldn't take the count, throws him back outside the ring.
Savage back up on that top rope. Here he comes. That's a drop of about 9 or 10 feet from up where Savage is down to the floor. Oh.
Okay.
Boy, Savage is just really, really working over Johnson. Off the middle rope, and he just lands right square on his chest. That's it. Mm. Boy, I tell you what, power, just raw power from Savage. It's over. He grabs Johnson and throws him out of the ring on the other side. Match is over. Savage has it won. The pin has occurred. There's Savage up on that top rope. He's just standing there. Johnson now struggling back to his feet down there, and Savage off the rope right down on the top of his head again. The match again is over. Pin has been made. The winner, Savage, still beating on him over there. Sound the bell again. Referee Jerry Calhoun trying to get him separated, and now Savage leaving. The time out at 1:26, and your official winner is Randy Savage.
They're standing here seeing the smiling manager of Randy Macho Man Savage. Now, there's no excuse in beating up on somebody like that.
I agree. There's no excuse. That's why we did it. We beat him up. We have no excuses. And you know something? You know who that was lying on the mat? That wasn't some poor boy down there. You know who that was? That was Jerry the King Lawler. How in the world? You know, I always thought Lawler, who is a superior wrestler, I give him every credit in the book. But Jerry Lawler, when it comes to intelligence, you have met your match in the Tux Man. It was the Tux Man that beat you, and now Randy Macho Man Savage has that AWA title. Coming up this Monday night, how you could ever show your face in the Mid-South Coliseum is beyond me.
Hey, he will show
you
his
know?
Face.
Because
make book on it.
You have been beaten. You have no guts. You laid there last time. You got whipped like a dog, and you didn't get up. You sat there. You were just finished. And why you want to get another beating from this man, Randy Macho Man Savage, is beyond me. Take a look at the power of this
Take
man.
Take a look at me, man.
He wants the belt back. That's exactly why he's going to climb through the ropes, and he wants to get the belt back around his waist.
The throning of the king. Tell him to come down, and we're going to finish it up. Southern heavyweight titles. Aren't you happy, baby? Aren't you happy?
I hear it. That's why the match is coming up Monday night down there.
Hurt. Lawler, we're going to hurt you. And I mean bad, because you dare to come back Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. The South will never see you again. I promise you.
Okay.
And we're celebrating the Hollywood again.
We're going to take time out.
I'm going to try to get, let's see, I'm going to try to get Clark Gable. No, he's gone. But I'm going to try to get all the stars I can, and we are going to party all week long. You are going to still be the champion.
Well, you better get it out before Monday night comes, because the championship will be on
the line. Okay, great, Lance Russell.
We're going to take a break, and we'll be back in just a moment. From the opening bout on through on the action coming up Monday night down at the Mid-South Coliseum. Bell time, of course, is 8 o'clock. Regular prices are in effect, and the children 10 and under can be admitted to general admission for just a buck, which means a doggone good opportunity for the family to come on down as a family unit and not have to reach too deep down in that pocket to see some excellent action. Monday night, 8 o'clock, Mid-South Coliseum. You can get your tickets up till 5 today at the Mid-South Coliseum. You can get them all of the Ticketmaster locations. And this just gives you kind of an idea while you want to be there bright and early. Young Jerry Oskey that we had out here not too long ago will be opening up, going against Big Iron Mike Sharp. Sharp and Oskey is an opening match, and it's a dandy to say the least. The very next match is a spectacular bout, and that's going to be a mixed tag match when Speedy Tall Trees joins with Debbie Combs, and they'll be going against Adrian Street and Miss Linda in that mixed tag match, a dandy and a half. Sweet Daddy Siki will be on the card. He was scheduled to go against Tracy Smothers. That's when Tux Newman had him booked in here on that. Sweet Daddy will be on the card. I'm not certain that he is going to be going against Tracy Smothers, but he, in fact, will be wrestling down at the Coliseum. Steve Constant and Tim Ashley will be going against the PYT. Is that a dandy?
That's a good match. Oh, yeah.
Boy, you better believe it. Constant and Ashley, who have been improving tremendously, will be going against Coco Ware and Norvell Austin, the PYT. Brother, they looked absolutely devastating in their return to championship wrestling today. That should be a whale of a tag match, to say the least. Dutch Mantell going against Mr. Wrestling. We'll see the Dutchman back for the second week, and delighted at that, to say the least, too. Southern Tag Team title match. Eddie Gilbert, Lanny Poffo teaming up together again. This week, they went against the Fabulous Ones. They looked good as a tag team. I got to give the devil his due. But, of course, the Fabs, excitement, they are always awesome. Stan and Steve will be defending the Southern Tag Belts against Gilbert and Poffo. And then there will be the return Southern Heavyweight title match. Randy Savage defending against the King, who is searing irritated, brother. I can tell you that for a fact. He's making no excuses. He didn't even want to dwell on how the belt was won. All he wants is his shot to get it back, and he will get it Monday at the Coliseum. You better believe it'll be a good time for you to be there. 8 o'clock's the bell time. Get your tickets today. We're going to take time out for a word or two, and then we'll be back in the ring in just a moment.
It's a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Wrestling under the mask at 233 pounds, the Destroyer. And going against him from Oil Trough, Texas, 229 pounds, Dutch Mantell. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Referee Jerry Calhoun.
Okay, the Dutchman ready to do it. The bell has sounded, and here we go, David.
All right, looking forward to this one. The Dutchman back in action. Back in the area after being gone for a while. We're glad he's back. Putting a twist. A little pressure on the shoulder there with the Destroyer. Destroyer. Forehead of the mask into the top turnbuckle. Dutch Mantell showing no mercy early in the match. Dutch got the headlock on him. With a forearm across the back, Destroyer kind of shoves Mantell back in the corner. He does it, goes to work with a fist and an upper arm. Mantell comes out of there battling. Dutchman clotheslines him, and the Destroyer hits the mat. Dutch not going for the cover at this point. He picks him up. Body slam. Dutch Mantell looking for a corner, a little momentum. He drops down. There's a cover. Might be it. Count is one, two, And he got it. Dutch Mantel just kind of taking care of business here, going against the man under the mask, the Destroyer. Mantel wins it in a minute, 25 seconds. Take a look at how he did it. Dutch in control here. He went to the corner. There's the momentum, and as he comes out of there, he drops. See that upper arm? It lands right across the chest. The Destroyer's not going to move from this point on. The three count, and Dutch Mantel has the win. We got more championship wrestling coming up. We'll be back with it in just a moment. Back in that ring, we'll be seeing the Fabs in action coming up right after just a moment. Right now, Oil Trump, Texas, number one citizen Dutch Mantel with a friend of his draped around his neck. Dutchman after a good win in there.
Oh, thank you, Lance. I tell you, it's real good to be back. Hello, Memphis. How you doing, baby? It's real good to be back here. You know, I went to Florida for a while. Like I said, I missed the winter and everything, but I'm back in here. I'm going full blast. Now,
going Monday night against
I'm going Monday night against this guy named Mr. Wrestling. Now, the funny thing about it, now, Tux Newman, a lot of people don't know this, and I'm sure Tux Newman's not going to let it out, but Tux Newman tried to get a hold of me this past week because last week I wrestled Iron Mike Sharp. Now, I don't know what Tux has got in mind, but he had his little bubble burst this morning when that sweet daddy Siki wouldn't team up with him, which I think is the best decision he could ever make.
Yes, sir.
But if he ever thought about trying to manage Dutch Mantel, then, baby, he's backing way up, Jack. Now, Tux, you take that, put it in your pipe, and smoke it. Because a lot of people are going to get wise to you, and they're going to get wise to you real, real quick. Like I say, I'm glad to be back. Now, this Mr. Wrestling, I've seen him wrestle a couple of times, has a very unorthodox wrestling style, but then again, so do I. So we're going to match him up. We're going to pit him face to face, and we're going to see who the best man is Monday night. And I think that best man is going to be me. Mr. Wrestling, we're going to have a fight. And you're not going to win it. I don't care if you want to take it outside on Union Avenue or wherever, but I'm going to come out on top in that match.
Okay, Dutchman, we're looking forward to seeing that action. You're the kind of guy who never needed anybody to manage your affairs but Dutch Mantel and occasionally a little help from a friend.
Yeah, you know, while I was gone, I changed the name. You called it Bessie, but I call it Shoe Baby now. It's my friend, never more than a few feet from me at any given time. Lance, nice talking to you.
Dutch,
a lot of big things are going to be happening around here, and I want to be a part of it.
The Dutchman, and coming in right behind him, here's a couple of guys that you can hear the electricity firing through the air. Their excitement whenever they come around. Steve, my boy, Stan, by golly, I'll tell you what, we're delighted to have you here. Looking forward to seeing you in the ring here in just a moment. But I do want to talk about the fact you got the Southern Tag Belts going up on the line Monday night.
Yeah, you know, Lance, we're not out here like Randy Macho Man Savage displaying those titles on somebody's old fireplace grill. But we got the belt, and we are the champions. You know, as for his illegitimate brother, Lanny Poffo, we can't figure out why he's changed his name. But him and Hot Stuff Gilberts have kind of, like, put together a little deal with, what's that guy's name, Tex? Tux? I can't figure out that guy's name. But he hasn't been doing so good today already, but he's got this team together. And now we've got a no disqualification and no time limit.
Woo!
Well, you know, all we have to do is call Jackie Fargo for our advice. And you know what Jackie had to say about Tux or Tex or whatever his name
What's
is?
What's that?
No problem. He says, just go right on by him. He says, wipe out Hot Stuff, take care of Leaping Lanny, and then come on back and bring the belts home, boys. And that's exactly what we're going to do, Lance.
Sound like a good order to me.
You know, it's not just Poffo and Gilbert. It's anybody, Lance. We've said it a million times, and I'll say it again. The Fabs have an open contract. You don't have to come beg us. You don't have to crawl up on your hands and knees and say, please give me a title, because we're easy. If you don't think we're easy, ask some of these girls. No, I'm just kidding. But let me tell you something. We got an open contract, brother. Anybody, anytime, any place, you come on down and put your little John Henry, or in case of the PYT, put a little X there, and you come on down, because the Fabs are ready. We got the belts. We got them shined up, bought a little brasso, and they're looking good, and we're looking good, and Memphis is looking good. So come on down and get you some of the Fabs, baby.
Okay, Stan and Steve, good luck to you in here right now. You got one coming up. Let's go to the ring.
All right. Stan and Steve.
Fabulous one. Talk to the crowd. There are their opponents up in the ring right here. Two high fives out of ringside.
These guys give you a high five and knock you flat.
That's true. They're up on the ring apron now for their one fall, 10-minute time limit tag team match. Get ready on the other side of the ring at a total of 565 pounds. From France, the Angel. And from the Ozark Mountains, J.R. Hall. Going against them at 459 pounds, both from Florida, Steve Kern, Stan Lane, the fabulous one. One fall, 10-minute time limit match, Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
Okay, there's our referee, Mr. Calhoun, and look at those two specimens. Are they not something? The fabulous ones, Stan and Steve, and we're ready for the action. Starting out will be J.R.
J.R., that's Harley.
It is Harley.
Yeah. Beg your pardon.
Given the wrong information. I looked up in there, and behind all that hair, it's hard to tell. Look at Stan Lane. Uh-oh, the Angel reaches in, grabs a hold, and gets him off of it. Steve takes the tag. The whip goes to the rope. A double backdrop, and I mean, they fired him. Almost did a two and a half.
He sure did.
Over that. Oh, can these guys get it on? Steve Kern hanging in there with Harley Hall. Harley's partner today is not brother J.R., but the Angel. Stan Lane, double whip, double elbow. Little teamwork. May not be legal, but it gets the job done for the Fab. Stan Lane goes behind him, dumps him over, and a tag goes to the Angel.
Nice move by Stan. He figured a way to get him off his feet. Unfortunately, close to the corner, so the Angel gets the tag, and the fresh man is in there.
Steve coming over the top rope on the second rope. They've got a little mannerism, particularly Steve. He really will give you a little different look when he gets ready to act.
I tell you what, I believe the Fabs are ready. Steve reversal. Nice move. Wow.
He takes the out of that corner. Whoa, the fabulous ones are smoking today.
The Angel with a right fist. He got Stan with that one.
I think, the referee signifying the tag was made. Steve comes over the top, gets the one, two, three. Yeah.
Yes, sir. All right, fabulous one. Nice teamwork as they take the much larger team of King Harley Hogg and the Angel. Boy, they outweighed the fabulous ones by 100 pounds, but take a look at it. Boy, the agility of these guys in the ring and the teamwork. There's the Angel. He goes into the rope, and there is Steve. He powered him down to the mat. He just knocked him down, covered him in the count of three, and that was it as the fabulous ones get the win.
Okay, David, don't go too far away because we're going to go right back in the ring again. Standing now, Eddie Gilbert, Lanny Poffo. I will look at it later. I wouldn't dare take a peek at it now. I just wanted to know if you by any chance happened to see the action of Stan and Steve, the Fab, just then. Kind of impressive, aren't they?
That's right. They're very impressive. They're going to look more impressive when Leaping Lanny and Eddie Hot Stuff Gilbert are on top of them and beat them in the ring. And we will be the new Southern Tag Team Champions because I am the greatest at predictions, and you know that. This tag team of the Leap and Hot Stuff is unbeatable and unstoppable. And any team that we're going up against, brother, don't ever think that you can beat us. The new Southern Tag Team Champions, and don't forget.
Well, the Southern Tag Champs have said, just come on. They'd be glad to take on all comers.
Lance, you made a very good point. I've been surveying the competition, and you're right. They are fabulous, and that's why they're called the Fabulous Ones. And more important than that, that's why they're the Southern Tag Team titles. But as far as predictions, I have no predictions until those titles change hands.
Okay, well, we'll find it out. Gilbert and Poffo heading to the ring right now. Dave, let's have the introduction.
All right, another tag team match. One fall, 10 minutes. Total weight, 443 pounds over on the right of the screen. From Memphis, Tennessee, Jesse Owens and his partner from California, Speedy Talltree, going against him. A total of 451 pounds. From St. John's, New Brunswick, Canada, Lanny Poffo and his partner from Lexington, Tennessee, Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. This match, one fall, 10. Gary Calhoun is again the referee.
Oogie-doo, starting out will be Speedy Talltrees against Leap and Lanny, and there ought to be a lot of movement in this. We have seen Speedy Talltrees one time previously on Championship Wrestling. He is not blessed with being the biggest wrestler we've ever seen, but, brother, he can move. Look at that bridge and back over with Poffo. There's just some of the movement, but you notice Speedy held right on to that headlock, Dave.
Did indeed. You got a couple of guys going against each other right here. Both of them very quick in the ring. Oh, nice move. Shoulder butt by Speedy. He slides under Poffo. Poffo being outmaneuvered here. Eddie Gilbert jumps in. He went right by.
Whoa.
Nice drop kick by Talltree, and both of them out of the ring. Poffo and Gilbert have both been run out of the ring by Speedy Talltree.
Pound for pound, he's got to be one of the most aggressive wrestlers we've seen in the ring, as Speedy Talltree. When you can outmaneuver a guy like Lanny Poffo, you've done something. You see that maneuver coming up, hit that top rope, sprung right in, and Talltree was right on top of him. Lanny Poffo caught in a side headlock standing. He goes right into Gilbert after the tag. Picked up in the air by Gilbert, holds on to that side mare and takes him over.
Good move by Gilbert there. He hooked his leg and pulled it out from under it.
Yeah, Eddie can wrestle. No two ways about that. He and Poffo both can get it around, but Talltree right back into the side headlock, and he grabs Lanny Poffo, who just entered the ring. Beautiful move.
Young man has balance. Well, he got a two count on him.
Right.
Couldn't make it 6-3.
Yeah.
You know, one advantage, though, that is right now with the team of Poffo and Gilbert, they've been able to keep fresher man in the ring. Here is the tag, though, on Jesse Owens coming in. That's what Talltree and Owens need to do. A little better teamwork at getting in and out of the ring, perhaps.
They lose a lot of speed when Jesse comes in there, and Eddie Gilbert, taking advantage, just starts pounding away on Jesse. Puts him down to one knee, slams back at him. There's a tag on Speedy Talltree. Eddie Gilbert being assaulted as Talltree going right to work.
He's double teamed. Lanny from around behind. Look out, Jesse Owens thrown out of the ring by Eddie Gilbert.
Jesse down on the deck, and Lanny Poffo comes out with Eddie Gilbert, grabbing Jesse Owens, holding him. And here comes Talltree, straight over the top rope, leaps in between him and breaks it up. Poffo slamming down on Talltree as Eddie Gilbert throws Jesse back in the ring. With Speedy still down on the floor, a double team and a heavy foot. Poffo did that front flip right off, landed on him. It's going to be a pin. One, two, three, and that is it. Okay, we're going to take time out. We'll be back in just a moment.
Championship wrestling action coming up around the territory, beginning tonight over in Jonesboro, Arkansas. Take a look at this card. The King will be there. Constant and Ashley, Macho Man, Randy Savage, and PYT, all of them tonight in Jonesboro, Arkansas. The box office will be open at 3 o'clock this afternoon, so you can buy your tickets in advance and be ready for the big action tonight in Jonesboro. Tomorrow night, Sunday night, March 24th, Cape Girardeau, Missouri for championship wrestling action. Time is 7 o'clock. And Jerry the King Lawler will be headlining an all-star championship wrestling card. It is tomorrow night, Cape Girardeau, Missouri, wrestling time, 7 o'clock. Thursday night in Hayti, Missouri. On Friday night, championship wrestling will be in Ecru, Mississippi. Friday night in Terrell, Arkansas at the high school. The Fabulous Ones will be there. Saturday, March 30th in Paris, Tennessee, up at Henry County High School. It's sponsored by the Henry County GCs. Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert, Constant, and Ashley, the Fabulous Ones, all on the card at Saturday the 30th in Paris, Tennessee. Friday, April 5th, Blytheville, Arkansas at the American Legion Arena. On Saturday, April 6th, Championship Wrestling moves to Malden, Missouri at the high school. Friday the 12th in Milan, Tennessee, the Fabulous Ones and more. Saturday night the 13th in Senatobia, Mississippi. And on Sunday, April 14th, Championship Wrestling will be back for another super spectacular in Jackson, Tennessee. Don't forget tonight in Jonesboro, Arkansas. And the box office will be open in Jonesboro at 3 this afternoon for your advance tickets. We're going to be back with more Championship Wrestling after this short break.
Alrighty, we're going to be back in the ring here in just a few minutes for our final match. Standing here with the exotic Adrian Street, who will be involved in a match coming up Monday night with Miss Linda as his partner, going against the team of Debbie Combs and Speedy Tall Trees in a mixed tag match. Adrian?
That should be a piece of cake for us. You know, I've taught Linda unarm combat and all the rest of it. As you know, she can look after herself very well. And I won't even start to talk about myself.
Well, she found out that Debbie Combs is pretty tough in her own right when they met in a single match down at the Coliseum.
Yes, but of course Linda beat her quite easily.
Yeah, but you all didn't mention the fact that Adrian Street was involved in that match, too. Yes, he was.
The only reason I went to the ring was to congratulate Linda on a victory. Linda would never interfere in a match of mine, as you well know. And I would never interfere with a match of Linda's, as you well know.
Well, I'll tell you what. You all just stand right here, because we've got a little tape of that match that was between, supposedly, Miss Linda and Debbie Combs. You make your own judgment as to whether Adrian Street is going out there to congratulate or not. Let's take a look at it. Again, she's bounced on the mat. Linda, with that long hair she has, having a difficult time seeing Debbie Combs at times, it looks like. Oh, boy. Linda's got at the throat. She's got a chain in there, Randy. I swear she does around her neck. We're catching a glimmer of something shining, and she is just choking Debbie Combs. Linda really getting vicious at her. I believe she's got that chain around her neck and is just jerking her head back and forth. A little something she picked up from Adrian, no doubt. A gentleman wouldn't point it out, but I got to remark that after the punishment from Debbie, it split the tights of Miss Linda. Linda is now in trouble, and Debbie's got it. Uh-oh, what is this? The crowd hollering. Here comes Adrian Street. Street in there. Slams Debbie Combs down. Crowd hollering. Come on, Dutch. Here he is. Gonna be it. Well, I think the people have made their judgment as to whether you came in to congratulate or not.
Doesn't that just prove you can't believe all you see? I've never seen such a good job of trick photography. The only reason I went down there was to congratulate Linda. She would never interfere in my match. I would never interfere in hers. Yeah. And I would never go after any girl. You can bet your life on that.
Both of you are going to be in there legally when you go against Debbie Combs and Speedy Tall Trees, and all of that we will see Monday night. We're going to be seeing Adrian back in the ring right after we take time out for this. You know, know, they ought to have a sign, Land or Mars, something on their jacket.
We're talking about the bat. They're so difficult to tell apart. Okay, Dave.
All right, this is going to be a match to the expiration of time. Introducing at a total weight of 454 pounds out of Charleston, West Virginia. You're looking at them right there, the Batten twins, Mark and Brad. And going against them at a total weight of 443 pounds, from parts unknown, Mr. Wrestling and his partner from the Royal Forest of Dean, with his valet, Miss Linda, the exotic Adrian Street. This match for the expiration of time, Jerry Calhoun will be the referee.
Okay, we've got some time here for this match, and I'm looking forward to it. A very, very classy young team of the Batten Twins. We love them. Going against a veteran team of Mr. Wrestling and Adrian Street, and here we go.
All right, that's Brad in there starting against Mr. Wrestling. Brad with a headlock. Mr. Wrestling trying to gain advantage. A hip toss by Mr. Wrestling, but he missed when he was going to drop with the upper arm. Batten on his feet. Batten twins make a tag. Mark coming in now. Mr. Wrestling over to the corner makes a tag. And here's the exotic one, Adrian Street. Dancing around, skipping around the ring. Boy, he can move, I tell you. Grab the boot. He hit Batten right at the top of the head with it. Look at that, boy. Took his feet away from him, Batten down on the mat. Hmm. He snapped his fingers there. Adrian Street really working on Mark Batten. Boot to the top of the forehead. Adrian Street came in. He took the tag from Mr. Wrestling, and now Batten battling back. Adrian Street trying to keep him away from the tag, and it looks like he has done it, at least for the time being. Yeah, he's done it, all right. Knee to the midsection. Oh, upper arm, and Street through the corner makes the tag on Mr. Wrestling. Batten trying to reach the corner. He was on his hands and knees, and he was about 4 feet away from the tag. He did not get it. He has to stay in there. His brother is still out there waiting. Mr. Wrestling going to work on him. Batten went through his legs. Does it again. Can he get the tag? Yes, sir. Got it. And the Batten's got the fresh man in there. Mr. Wrestling goes to work on him with a big broad arm, right arm. Hangs on to the ropes. Referee says they need a break. He gets it. Batten steps away. That allows Wrestling, Mr. Wrestling, to get off the rope. Mr. Wrestling really putting the punishment on the left arm. Time winding down here in this expiration of time. There was a boot by Batten. Mr. Wrestling, kind of a half suplex, dumps him down to the mat. Leaves him there, and the tag made on the exotic one. Adrian Street comes in. Boot to the top of the head a couple of times. Batten picked up off the mat and kneeled by Street. Miss Linda leading the cheers down at in Street and Mr. Wrestling's corner. That was legal. That was just plain old upper arm. That wasn't. That was a fist. Batten comes off the ropes. Boy, he nailed Street. Drove him all the way back to his corner, but Street comes back after him. He's got him from behind. Now, with Batten on the bottom rope, Street went after his brother back outside. There he is again with that powerful upper arm. He just fires at him. About 2 minutes remaining in the time limit. Time winding down here. Batten reverses. Mr. Wrestling jumps on his back off the ropes. The Battens make a tag. Mr. Wrestling nailed him. He's choking him. Referee tolling the count there on the choke. Mr. Wrestling with Batten on the mat, and he's got that hand wrapped around his throat, just choking away. Adrian Street from outside, aiding Mr. Wrestling. Mr. Wrestling trying to use the forearm. Now he grabs Batten, whips him into the rope. Batten ducks under. Look out. Good drop kick puts Mr. Wrestling down on the mat. Wrestling makes a tag. And here is exotic Adrian Street back in there. Batten putting the scissors on the left arm. Street just overpowered him. He just took him down to the mat. We got about a minute left. Time really running short here in this expiration of time match. Adrian Street puts him down. Ooh. He just smacked him. Street has been vicious in this match. Every time he's been in there, he has come in battling. Here's the tag made, Mr. Wrestling. Boy, I tell you what, he hasn't been a pushover either. The Battens have really, really had a battle on their hands here today. There's the knee lift. Mr. Wrestling trying to keep control of things.
It's been a dandy of a match in terms of the action going in there. And look at those Battens fighting back, Dave.
Yeah, you know, I was just thinking, I've been talking a lot about the viciousness of Mr. Wrestling and exotic Adrian Street. The Batten brothers have given a great account of themselves in this match, too. It's been a good one.
Time is running out. Look at here. Suplexed him all the way over. He goes over and tags Adrian Street. Street into the ring in there as our time is running down. He is going to go for another suplex as he got him up and over. And Street pounding in there. Our time running out, and he is going to miss the opportunity for a pin. He didn't even have an opportunity to make it there as a tag. And as the other Batten comes in, we are out of time. Oh, a beautiful drop kick going in there as Street pulled off of it a little. Our time is up. The action isn't up by any means. I'm telling you, they are pounding away on each other hard. As the Battens now jumping on Mr. Wrestling and Adrian, they were still ready to go at it in a lot of action, but the time is up. It's going to be a draw. We have had an expiration of time right here in the middle of this one. Better check our time, and we'll be back in just one moment. Want to remind you about getting the tickets today. You may not want to do it right now. We want to wish the Tigers a lot of luck going against Oklahoma. I do, in fact, want to tell you the ticket office down at the Coliseum. You can get them till about 5 o'clock down there, any of the Ticketmaster locations. Let me run over the card. Well, before I run over the card, let me get promoter Eddie Marlin in there.
I just want to assure you and all the people and Sweet Daddy that he will be wrestling on the card Monday night.
All right, I love that.
I haven't got an opponent for him, but we will have him on the card Monday night.
You will have him on the card.
Marlin, I thought you had some kind of intelligence, but here Lawler and Seeky come running to you, saying, please, I beg you, let me wrestle, let Sweet Daddy wrestle. Well, he's not going to wrestle. He had a contract, and he ripped it up. That was my bread and butter, and he ripped it up and humiliated me on television, and he's not going to wrestle.
Let me tell you something, Tuff. You manage your men around ringside, and I book the cards. You have nothing to do with the cards.
Let me tell you one thing. You can bring...
Wait a minute. I got news for you. If he's on the card Monday night, then you're not going to wrestle one man. You're going to wrestle two of my men. Two against you.
You don't book the cards. I book the cards, and he'll wrestle who I say he wrestles, and not you.
Well, if he's got any guts, Marlon, put him in against two of my men.
One second. I'll wrestle one. I'll wrestle two. I'll wrestle four.
You don't have to.
Whatever you say. I bet I'll come out the victor.
You don't have to, Sweet.
And I'll tell you one thing. I want to tell all of my brothers and sisters to drop out to see me Monday night, because I will not let you down. I will not let you down.
Okay, fine. He'll be there. Hey, Tuck, will you take it on out of here, please? Okay, we got to get it on out of here. Dave, our time is up. We'll see you next week. Till that time, Lance Russell, Dave Brown saying bye-bye, everybody.
You know?
announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.